Einstein has given this equation, write down, H times mu minus phi naught is equal to K max. Write down, then we'll discuss. This is for one electron, for a particular electron. What will happen? Electron will absorb a photon. Okay? Electron will absorb a photon which has H into mu energy. Okay? And suppose it needs phi naught of energy to come out of metal surface. Okay? So if H into mu, which it has absorbed, is more than what energy it requires to come out, which is phi naught, then the difference between them will become the kinetic energy of that electron. Are you getting it? Fine. So if, I mean, in a metal surface, there will be different kinds of electron. Those will be directly on the surface. They will be able to come out the most easily. Those slightly below, they will be able to come out with slightly greater difficulty. Fine. So this thing will keep on varying for different kinds of electron. Fine. The minimum value of this, the minimum value or the minimum threshold value for any electron to come out is called the work function of the metal.
So it will be the last point.
The minimum threshold energy required for the electron to come out, the minimum energy, write down, the minimum energy for the electron to come out from the metal surface is called the work function of that metal surface. Getting it? So usually in the equation, phi naught is referred as work function. Fine. So this is the maximum kinetic energy of the electron that are coming out. What about minimum kinetic energy? How much it will be? Minimum will be what? Zero. You need phi naught amount of energy for it to come out. You give phi naught, you need phi naught, it takes phi naught and expend it to come out. It has now zero energy. Fine, the minimum energy when the electron comes out from the surface is zero. Maximum you can get from this equation. Fine. So there will be all kinds of electron that will be coming out from zero energy till maximum kinetic energy. But this will happen only when mu is more than threshold frequency. Fine. So can you find out how much is the threshold frequency using this equation? How will you find threshold frequency? Threshold frequency is when electron is just able to come out, or kinetic energy is minimum or zero. Fine. So put K zero here, you will get H times mu threshold minus phi naught is equal to zero. So mu threshold is phi naught by H. Fine. Do you know what is the value of H? What is this H called? Planck's constant. How much is this value? 6.6 7 6 6 6 3 6 10 power minus 34 34 SI units. Or, and many times it will be given that energy is in the form, many times energy will be given in the form of electron volts. So do you know what is the relation between electron volt and joules? No. 1 electron volt is how much? This is 1.6 if 10 to the power minus 19 joules. This is 1 electron volt. How much is 2 electron volt? 2 into this. 5 electron volt, 5 into this. Like that. Because you are dealing with very very less amount of energy. So So it makes sense to write energy in the form of electron volt. So we found out the threshold frequency. Now, can you find out the stopping potential? Stopping potential, write down, find the stopping potential of a metal surface. Stopping potential of a metal surface having work function phi for a frequency mu. For a frequency mu and work function phi, find out the stopping potential. How much it is? Done? K max is what? In terms of stopping potential, how much it is?
EV
naught. Right? So you can just write H mu minus phi naught is equal to EV naught. Fine. So you'll get V naught equal to H by E mu minus phi naught by E. So you can see that you get a straight line relation between V naught and mu, or a linear relation. This is what the graph is when we have plotted. Okay. So when V naught is 0, you'll get the frequency mu, that is the threshold frequency. And the slope of the graph is H by E. That has nothing to do with what metal it is. One more thing you will see in the numerical is power of radiation. Okay. What is power? What is unit of power? Power is what? And what is what? Joules per second. So if power is P watt, okay, and every photon has H into mu energy, this many joules. So I'll be able to find out number of photons that are coming per second. How? Total energy per second is P joule per second. And one photon has H into mu joules. Fine. So if n photons are there per second, then n into h mu should be equal to power. N is number of photons emitted per second. Here. So this thing comes again and again in the numerical, number of photons per second. Acha, few more things. I mean, I'm just telling you based on my experience in the numericals. At times, you'll be able to find out the kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy of electron. And what is electron? A charged particle. So you'll have a velocity and you have a charge. And if you supply a magnetic field perpendicular to its velocity, it will move in a circle. You'll be able to find out the radius, because you'll be able to find the velocity. Radius is mv by qb. Fine. So all that can be done in the numerical. Okay. And the K max which you are finding from this equation is a maximum kinetic energy when it comes out from the emitter plate. Fine. When you supply a potential difference, it can further gain energy. Fine. So if you supply a potential difference of V naught, positive potential difference, then the total kinetic energy when it reaches the collector plate will be K max plus E times V naught. Are you getting it? Fine. So all that you have to be very, very careful about. And then you will not find many variations other than these. So that's all. I mean, if you solve like 30 to 40 questions your own, this chapter is done. Okay. Let's take few of the NCRT questions. Let's see how it goes. A monochromatic light of frequency 6 into 10 to the power 14 Hertz. And also in this chapter there will be a lot of calculations. So be ready to, for that. And you should be able to approximately find the answer. At times, many times in fact, you will be asked to find out energy and then you will be like, okay, doing this calculation again and again. Hc by lambda, and then you have to divide by charge of electron also to get the energy in electron volts. Fine. So you write like this: 6.63 into 10 raised to the power minus 34 into 3 into 10 raised to the power 8 divided by charge of electron, which is 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 into wavelength. What happens many times, I have seen that students will just remember this value, Hc by E. How much is that? Because this will come again and again. If you remember it, it is fine. But then, if you don't want to remember, then also you can, you know, this is approximately 4 times. But slightly more than 4. Okay? So 4 is a 12. So just write down 12.1 or 12.2. And that's it. 10 raised to the power. This is 27 minus 34. How much? Minus 7. This divided by number. Fine, so you should be quick in the calculation. You should be not like, okay, let me divide 6.63 and you put 1.6 over here. And this. By the time you do all this nonsense, people will be solving 2-3 questions. Okay. And these things, like, you learn only when you solve a lot of questions. Anyways, coming back to the numerical, the frequency is this. This frequency is produced by a laser. The power emitted by the laser is 2 into 10 to the minus 3 watt. The power is 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 watt. You need to find energy of the photon in the light beam. How much is the energy of photon? And how many photons per second are emitted? Photons per second that are emitted by this laser source.
Sir, energy, do we need to find the electron volts or?
Joules. If nothing is said, joules. How much?
Energy is 39.8 into 10 to the power minus 20 and number of electrons per second is 550.
Not electrons.
Photons. Photons.
Okay. Fine. You got it?
Yeah.
Energy is H into mu. Just multiply H with mu, you'll get energy. Okay? Number of photons per second into H into mu should be equal to 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 3. So if you divide H into mu from this, you get number of photons. One more thing, in the higher order questions, you will see that when electron comes out of metal surface, it's a charged particle that are leaving the metal surface. So the metal will continuously gain charge, more and more positive charge will gain. Okay? So we are assuming that metal remains neutral right now. If it gains charge with time, it will become increasingly difficult for electrons to leave the metal. Getting slowly and slowly by itself only electrons will not be able to come out, and at times in the numerical it will be given that okay, one electron out of 1 million photons will be able to come out. So you will be able to roughly find out what is the current. Like for example here itself, if I say that one, write down in the same question, If one electron out of 1 billion, not billion, 1 million, so one electron is ejected from 1 million photons, find out the current. Did you get? What is our answer? 5 into 10 raised to the power 15 photons per second. So how many electrons per second?
Divided by 10 to the power
6. So I will get 5 into 10 raised to the power 9 electrons are coming per second. How much charge per second? That is the current. This into charge of an electron, right? So this into charge of an electron, which is 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 ampere. Fine? Okay. So this is what? 5, 6 are 38 into 10 raised to the power minus 10 ampere.